EVT, an automotive test equipment and repair service. Your place where you can make one call to repair it all.
The procedure for using the ProCut begins with vehicle preparation. Raise the vehicle on the lift so the hub is about belt level. Be sure the vehicle is in neutral and check that the wheel bearings are snug, as any play can complicate operation of the lathe. Calipers should be removed and suspended out of the way of moving parts like half shafts and CV boots. Lug posts and wheel mounting surfaces on the rotor should be cleaned. Fall-off rotors should be cleaned on the inside as well. In general, you want to make sure that all rust should be removed from all contacting surfaces to ensure solid mating of hub, brake, and wheel components. Finally, before mounting the lathe, be sure to check cutting bits. These bits play a vital role in delivering high-quality surface finish. It's important that they be original Pro-Cut tips and properly mounted. Each tip has a life of 7 to 12 cuts per corner and should be rotated until all three corners have been used. You can monitor rotor surface finish to determine tip wear. If the rotor surface finish begins to look inconsistent or feels rough to the touch, bits should be rotated. Reviewing vehicle preparation. First, be sure the vehicle is in neutral and raise it until the hub is about belt level. You're going to want to check for excessive bearing play and correct any hub irregularities. Then remove the wheel and caliper. Be sure to clean all mating surfaces between the rotor, hub, and wheel before checking the cutting bits to make sure they're in good condition so you'll leave a good surface finish. The ProCut mounts directly to the hub of the vehicle at this center flange. As you can see, the cutting head of the brake lathe is to the right of the center flange. You will want to begin with the lathe right side up, as shown, with the cutting action where the caliper is normally mounted. To mount the machine, first select the correct adapter for the vehicle you're servicing. Passenger cars use either the 4-lug or 5-lug direct fit adapter. Most trucks and vans will require one of the larger adapters. This flat adapter is for dual-wheel trucks. A complete list of available adapters can be found in the owner's manual. Once you've selected the correct adapter, try each bolt pattern until you find one that fits the vehicle evenly. Using a hand wrench, secure the adapter in place with either the vehicle's lug nuts or the nuts provided with the machine. Be warned that adapters are not designed to withstand the use of impact tools. Again, do not use impact guns to attach these adapters. Roll the machine into place and attach it to the adapter. The lathe stand is spring-loaded to accommodate different heights. Each adapter has a dowel pin which must line up with one of two holes in the mounting flange. Once the flange is flush to the adapter, the shaft of the machine bolts onto the adapter by turning the large mounting knob. Snug this firmly and rotate the machine so the cutting head is in position to cut where the caliper was mounted. Then lock the machine in place by tightening the trolley handle. The cutting head must also be set. Notice the series of tapped holes in the slide plate and the slot in the cutting head. There's a 6mm T-handle Allen wrench included with the lathe that will allow you to move and center the head so the cutting arms will straddle the rotor. Before you tighten the securing screw, it is absolutely critical that you firmly press the head back into the dovetail groove in which it rides. While one hand is tightening the screw, the other hand must be firmly pushing the head back into the dovetail. If you fail to do this, surface finish will be compromised. Different vehicles have different offsets, so the head must be moved in or out for each vehicle. On large trucks, the head will be mounted as far out as it can possibly go, as shown here. Even though you can see that the head hangs over the edge of the base plate, the lathe will cut smoothly, provided the head is squarely pressed into the dovetail. Finally, be sure to bring the shutoff cam into position so the lathe will automatically shut down when the cutting head clears the rotor. Reviewing the important parts of mounting the lathe. First, be sure to start with the lathe in the right side up position. Select the correct adapter and mount it with a hand wrench. Never use impact tools. Mount the lathe to the adapter. Center and secure the cutting head, being sure the back edge is securely in the dovetail. Then set the automatic shutoff cam so it will engage when the cutting head clears the rotor.